Please stand as you are able. And if you want to look over your shoulder, there's some action back here. Let us pray. Today we celebrate the glorious resurrection of Jesus Christ, his triumphant victory over sin and death. May the light of Christ, who rises this day in glory, dispel the darkness of our hearts and minds and remind us of the paschal mystery in which we share. Christ, yesterday and today, the beginning and the end, the Alpha and the Omega, by his holy and glorious wounds, may Christ our Lord guard us and keep us. O life-giving God, through your Son, you have bestowed upon your people the brightness of your light. Sanctify and bless this candle. May it shine continually to drive away all darkness. Amen. People of God, Christ is risen from the dead, and his flame of love still burns within us. Christ sheds his peaceful light on all the world. Christ lived and reigns forever and ever. Amen.
Hallelujah! Christ is risen!
The Lord is risen indeed!
Hallelujah! Christ is risen!
The Lord is risen indeed!
Hallelujah! Christ is risen!
Thank you.
The Lord be with you. Let us pray. Almighty God, who through your only begotten Son, Jesus Christ, overcame death and opened to us the gate of everlasting life, grant that we, who celebrate with joy the day of the Lord's resurrection, may be raised from the death of sin by your life-giving Spirit. Through Jesus Christ our Lord, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen.
A reading from the Acts of the Apostles. Peter began to speak to Cornelius and the other Gentiles. I truly understand that God shows no partiality, but in every nation, anyone who fears him and does what is right is acceptable to him. You know the message he sent to the people of Israel, preaching peace by Jesus Christ. He is Lord of all. That message spread throughout Judea, beginning in Galilee, after the baptism that John announced, how God anointed Jesus of Nazareth with the Holy Spirit and with power, how he went about doing good and healing all who were oppressed by the devil, for God was with him. We are witnesses to all that he did, both in Judea and Jerusalem. They put him to death by hanging him on a tree. But God raised him on the third day and allowed him to appear, not to all people, but to those who were chosen by God as witnesses and who ate and drank with him after he rose from the dead. He commanded us to preach to the people and to testify that he is the one ordained by God as judge of the living and the dead. All the prophets testify about him, that everyone who believes in him receives forgiveness of sins through his name. The word of the Lord.
Thank you.
A reading from the first letter of Paul to the Corinthians. If for this life only we have hoped in Christ, we are of all people most to be pitied. But in fact, Christ has been raised from the dead, the first fruits of those who have died. For since death came through a human being, the resurrection of the dead was also come through a human being. For as all die in Adam, so all will be made alive in Christ. But each in his own order, Christ the first fruits, then at his coming, those who belong to Christ, then comes the end, when he hands over the kingdom to God the Father, after he has destroyed every ruler and every authority and power. For he must reign until he has put all his enemies under his feet. The last enemy to be destroyed is death. The word of the Lord.
Jesus Christ, according to John.
Glory to you, Lord Christ.
Early on the first day of the week, while it was still dark, Mary Magdalene came to the tomb and saw that the stone had been removed from the tomb. So she ran and went to Simon Peter and the other disciple, the one whom Jesus loved, and said to them, "They have taken the Lord out of the tomb, and we do not know where they have laid him." Then Peter and the other disciples set out and went toward the tomb. The two were running together, but the other disciple outran Peter and reached the tomb first. He bent down to look in and saw the linen wrappings lying there, but he did not go in. Then Simon Peter came following him and went into the tomb. He saw the linen wrappings lying there and the cloth that had been on Jesus' head, not lined with the linen wrappings, but rolled up in a place by itself. Then the other disciple who reached the tomb first also went in, and he saw and believed. For as yet they did not understand the scripture, that he must rise from the dead. Then the disciples returned to their homes. But Mary stood weeping outside of the tomb. As she wept, she bent over to look into the tomb and saw the two angels in white sitting where the body of Jesus had been lying, one at the head and the other at the feet. They said to her, "Woman, why are you weeping?" She said to them, They have taken away my Lord, and I do not know where they have laid him." When she had said this, she turned around and saw Jesus standing there, but she did not know that it was Jesus. Jesus said to her, "Woman, why are you weeping? Whom are you looking for?" Supposing him to be the gardener, she said to him, "Sir, if you have carried him away, tell me where you have laid him, and I will take him away." Jesus said to her, "Mary." And she turned and said to him in Hebrew, "Rabboni," which means teacher. Jesus said to her, "Do not hold on to me, because I have not yet ascended to the Father. But go to my brothers and say to them, I am ascending to my Father and to your Father, to my God and to your God." Mary Magdalene went and announced to the disciples, "I have seen the Lord." And she told them that he had said these things to her. The Gospel of our Savior.
Praise to you, Lord Christ.
In the name of the resurrected, living, and loving God. Amen. Wow, it's really great to be with you all this morning. Happy Easter. I gotta say, this is a resurrection moment for me right now. I mean, think about this. It's been 3 years since we have sat together in this space on this Easter day to celebrate this resurrection. And so I'm so grateful that we are here at this moment, and I want to celebrate that. And it's not the only resurrection moment of the last 3 years. I think back to 2020 when, you know, we were still sort of shell-shocked from the COVID circumstances, and we, you know, we offered all these totally virtual circumstances, and then realizing that Easter morning we just really couldn't do it the way we wanted to, we asked you all to partner and either we partnered with either Grace Cathedral or the National Cathedral, and said, "Go there for Easter because, you know, they've been doing this streaming stuff for years." And that was a resurrection moment in that time. A year ago, we had just gotten permission to gather together outside, 6 feet apart, masked, no singing. And so we came up with this crazy construct where we were outside in the courtyard. And if you weren't there, there's a picture of it on the front of your bulletin. And 2 days before, we were told that we would be allowed to sing together. So while we had these bells that we would ring, we got to sing together and ring our bells together last year. And I don't know if you know this, but we had five services back to back last year. And one of the local newspapers was doing an article up at that other church up the hill. And we like them. And they were there doing a news article about how churches are responding to COVID. And they heard us ringing our bells. And they were like, "What's going on down there?" And so their crew came down and interviewed some of our members. And we got this nice little shout out in the paper about how we were responding to our circumstances. And which, that was the initial discovery that led to our fall and early winter outdoor courtyard services, if you were a part of that. So that too, resurrection moment. So all of these moments and all of these opportunities, experiences, times in our lives, these are moments when we are reminded that the presence, the love, the grace of Christ is always with us. And what the resurrection today particularly tells us is that God shows up even when we think everything is lost and all is done. What we experience as the end, God says, I'm not done yet. And I got to tell you, I need to hear that in my life today. Because while I, on one hand, recognize that the resurrection resounds throughout the creation today, so does the crucifixion. You know, the war that we are totally aware of right now that is in Europe, the war that was never to happen again, is happening. And it also then reminds me of all the other wars that have happened in the last 40 or 50 years that we don't even hear about. I'm shocked by places in the country where I used to live, how they are denying the fullness of what it means to be human to women, to transgender people, to people of color. Those are crucifixion moments that the light of Christ is begging to be brought forth into. And that those are the big issues. I mean, let's look at even our local circumstances about some of the challenges today. I read an article in the paper last week about, you know, we all know that it's impossible for anybody who's like a teacher or a policeman or a fire person to live in the city. There was an article this week that said San Francisco, even the middle class is being priced out of. How does a city survive when people can't afford to live there? Not to mention still the circumstances of COVID that we're still adjusting to. And then, as if that isn't enough, what about all the normal things in our lives? The loss of a parent, the troubled circumstances of a child, a divorce, a difficult job transition, heck, a terrible boss. How do we experience the love, the grace, the possibility of Christ in things big and small? And our gospel today points to some of the ways that God does that with us and for us. We have this incredible story of Mary discovering the tomb, telling the disciples, and then more. So the first thing that announces Christ's resurrected presence is actually an experience of absence. The tomb is empty. Mary and the disciples are completely confused, and yet that sense of absence is actually a proclamation of God's, Christ's, real presence. And then the next thing is there's intermediaries. You have these angels who are pointing to the fact that Jesus is no longer there. He's among the living. And then, when the actual presence of Christ is there with Mary, he's unrecognizable. I wonder how many times I am begging for the presence of Christ in my life, and the presence is there, I just don't recognize it. And last, and this is a big one for me, and I love this, that God reveals God's self after the resurrection first to a woman. And this is huge back in that day and age because women had no rights, no autonomy. They were the lowest of society, just above maybe children. And yet it's the early church who calls Mary the apostle to the apostles, not the disciple to the apostles, the apostle to the apostles. It is Mary who proclaims the good news to the world. And in our world today, where white women make 83 cents on the dollar of their white male peers, and women of color make even less, this witness to the fullness of responsibility and authority of women in our lives is profound. And yet the part that gets me every year from this scripture is what is it that Mary finally realizes that it is her loving and living Lord in her midst? She sees him, she's talking to him, and yet the moment of truth is when he calls her name, Mary. And in that intimate moment, that relational moment, she understands. I remember as a child being taught songs and being told that God knows me by name, knows every part of me and loves every part of me. And it's that awareness of deep and abiding and transforming love that's made it possible for me to manifest and engage all other levels of love as well. This is a love project that we're a part of. I remember going on a youth, I was a youth leader, and I remember going on a weekend mission, not mission trip, sorry, midwinter retreat for high schoolers one year, and this one teenager who was delightful, and because of some circumstances in life, had some challenges that, you know, shouldn't be there, but they were. And she came on this weekend, and, you know, honestly, my experience of the weekend was like, it was great. I mean, it was fine. It wasn't anything profound. But for her, something happened that weekend. And at the end of it, she said this. She said, I always knew that God loves us. But this weekend, I felt and understood and now know that God loves me. It's the intimate call to every one of our lives that can resound through our lives to the healing of the entire world. And so whatever you are going through, whatever we're going through, whatever the world is going through, the proclamation and the invitation to us that Jesus is saying is that this is not the end. And we're invited to be a part of the fulfilling of God's creation. God is here in ways that are often difficult to understand, calling us by our name with deep and transforming love, inviting us to be a part of the deep and transforming love of the world. Easter is the resounding message that God loves us. Really, really loves us. All of us, every part of our individual selves, every living being, all of creation, and that nothing, nothing gets in the way of that love. Happy Easter.
Please stand and let us reaffirm our faith in the words of the Nicene Creed. We believe in one God, the Father, the Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all that is, seen and unseen. We believe in one Lord, Jesus Christ, the only Son of God, eternally begotten of the Father, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, of one being with the Father, through him all things were made. For us and for our salvation, he came down from heaven. By the power of the Holy Spirit, he became incarnate from the Virgin Mary and became truly human. For our sake, he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried. On the third day, he rose again in accordance with the scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. We believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son. With the Father and the Son, she is worshiped and glorified. She has spoken through the prophets. We believe in one holy Catholic and apostolic church. We acknowledge one baptism for the forgiveness of sins. We look for the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen.
Alleluia, for Christ is risen and continues to walk among us. Let us confidently bring before God the needs of our world. Gracious One, breathe the Holy Spirit upon your church and its ministers, that we may be reawakened to your glorious majesty. Be healers in this world and instruments of your peace. Your presence brings fullness of joy. Gracious God,
hear our prayer.
Eternal One, guide the leaders of our nation and all in authority to embrace the compassionate example of Christ, that they may spread his blessing of peace and justice to those most unloved. Your presence brings fullness of joy. Gracious God,
hear our prayer.
Merciful One, bring us to new life. Awaken in us a faithfulness that manifests itself in love, in work of reconciliation throughout the world, in care for your creation, and in awe of your glory. Your presence brings fullness of joy. Gracious God,
hear our prayer.
Gentle One, cast out all fear and soothe unbearable grief. We pray for those throughout the world who bear witness to a litany of unending horrors. Grant that we may shoulder their pain and recommit to being a community of loving action that nurtures hope for all. Your presence brings fullness of joy. Gracious God,
hear our prayers.
Holy One, let your Son's resurrection bring all who've died into your eternal presence, that they may have new life in Christ who triumphed over death, especially those whose earthly lives have been extinguished by war, gun violence, or from disease. Your presence brings fullness of joy. Gracious God,
hear our prayer.
God of love, we rejoice with all the hosts of heaven as we celebrate the resurrection of your Son. Hear our words of thanksgiving and praise as we shout out our gratefulness, especially for being together once again in our sanctuary and for those we hold most closely in our hearts. Your presence brings fullness of joy. Gracious God,
reveal yourself unto the whole world, O Holy One, and heal the grief, anxiety, and yearning of your creation this morning of a new dawn, that all hearts may be lifted, all souls rejoice, and all humanity rest secure in the life of the Holy Spirit through Jesus Christ our Savior. Amen. Alleluia. The peace of the risen Christ be always with you. Please greet one another with a sign of peace.
Once again, thank you so much for being with us this morning. Go ahead and have a seat for a brief moment. I'm so delighted. I hope you can tell how delighted I am that you're here today. If you are new or visiting with us here on site, if you're new or visiting with us there at home, we're delighted that you're with us. And if you'd like to know more about the life of love and grace here at St. Mary's, we invite you to check out the website smvsf.org or talk to someone in the courtyard afterwards. Just delighted that you're here. In just a few moments, we're going to be inviting an offering to the Life of Love and Grace here at St. Mary's. What you give will go towards our mission to receive the love of God and to bear Christ into the world. So we thank you for your generosity. And then we're going to turn our attention to this table, where we will first witness and then participate in the very becoming of God among us. First as bread and wine, and then into our lives through that bread and wine, and then into the world through our lives. All are welcome to come forward and receive. Just a bit of instruction. Currently, we are only offering the Eucharist in one kind, the bread. However, don't worry theologically. The fullness of the entire sacrament is in both kinds. So wine will return at some point, but you're not missing out on anything. Jesus is fully there in the bread. We're going to have three stations, two here up at this altar, one in the chapel. And the ushers will direct you where to go. So you in the balcony, don't worry, an usher will come get you. We will not strand you up there. Please come forward. If you'd like to receive, put your hands out in front of you like this, and a person will put a wafer in your hand, and then you can then eat that wafer and return to your seat. If you'd like to come forward and simply receive a blessing, please come forward and put your arms over your chest like this, and you can receive a blessing. And you are welcome to simply stay in your seat as well and enjoy the music and the experience. And again, thank you so much for being here. Walk in love as Christ loves us and gave himself for us and rose for us, a living and loving sacrifice to God.
Thank you.
The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts.
We lift them to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right
and a good and joyful thing always and everywhere to give thanks to you, Almighty God, Creator of heaven and earth. But chiefly are we bound to praise you for the glorious resurrection of your Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord. For he is the true Paschal Lamb who was sacrificed for us and has taken away the sin of the world. By his death he has destroyed death, and by his rising to life again he has won for us everlasting life. Therefore we praise you, joining our voices with angels and archangels and with all the company of heaven, who forever sing this hymn to proclaim the glory of your name. Holy and gracious Father, in your infinite love you made us for yourself, and when we had fallen into sin and become subject to evil and death, you in your mercy sent Jesus Christ, your only and eternal Son, to share our human nature, to live and die as one of us, to reconcile us to you, the God and Father of all. He stretched out his arms upon the cross and offered himself in obedience to your will, a perfect sacrifice for the whole world. On the night he was handed over to suffering and death, our Lord Jesus Christ took bread, and when he'd given thanks to you, he broke it and gave it to his disciples and said, "Take, eat. This is my body which is given for you. Do this for the remembrance of me." After supper, Jesus took the cup of wine, and when he'd given thanks, he gave to them and said, "Drink this, all of you. This is my blood of the new covenant, which is shed for you and for all for the forgiveness of sins. Whenever you drink it, do this for the remembrance of me." Therefore, we proclaim the mystery of faith. Christ has died. Christ is risen. Christ will come again. We celebrate the memorial of our redemption, Almighty God, in the sacrifice of praise and thanksgiving. Recalling Christ's death, resurrection, and ascension, we offer you these gifts. Sanctify them by your Holy Spirit to be for your people the body and blood of your Son, the holy food and drink of new and unending life in Christ. Sanctify us also, that we may faithfully receive this holy sacrament and serve you in unity, constancy, and peace. And at the last day, bring us with all your saints into the joy of your eternal kingdom. All this we ask through your Son, Jesus Christ. By Christ and with Christ and in Christ, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all honor and glory is yours, Almighty Father, now and forever. Amen. And now, as our Savior Christ has taught us, we are bold to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom and the power and the glory forever and ever. Amen. Alleluia, alleluia, Christ our Passover is sacrificed for us.
of God for the people of God. Take them in remembrance that Christ died for you, and feed on him in your hearts by faith with thanksgiving. Thank you.
Let us pray. Almighty God, who through your only begotten Son, Jesus Christ, overcame death and opened to us the gate of everlasting life, grant that we who celebrate with joy the day of the Lord's resurrection may be raised from the death of sin by your life-giving Spirit, through Jesus Christ our Lord, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen. And may the blessing of the resurrected God, the God who really, really loves you, be with you and remain with you always. Amen.
Hallelujah.